Welcome to the Beyond Me devotional by John McLean, a shared project with the Selah Time to Pause podcast from Plexus Salvation Army, an online church in the UK. Over these 40 days, we want to firstly deepen our appreciation for all that Christ did on the cross. Secondly, we want to understand what it means to live a life through the lens of the cross, to respond to the invitation of Christ to look beyond ourselves and realize that we are not only partakers in God's redemption plan, but we are called to participate in his mission to redeem our families, communities, and world. Together, we aim to express, embrace, and embody what it means to be redeemed by God. So grab your coffee and get ready to spend some time with God as we look beyond ourselves for a fresh encounter. If you haven't already, don't forget to join our Facebook listener group dedicated to the series, where you can share all your thoughts and personal reflections sparked by what we learn and hear in the podcast. Make sure to join us there by following the link in the description, which we've also shared on our social media, or by searching for Beyond Me Lent Devotional on Facebook. Each reflection has been written by John McLean and read by Joanne James. May you be blessed today. Today is day 31. Prepare the way.
Luke chapter 3 and verse 3. John the Baptist is sent to prepare the way for the Lord. He does this by preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins.
In her book, Openness Unhindered, Butterfield writes, "Of course, there is only one thing to do when you meet the living God. You must fall on your face and repent of your sins. Repentance is bittersweet business. Repentance is not just a conversion exercise. It is the posture of the Christian. Just like a dancer's body finds its points and an equestrian incorporates her body weight into the movement of the horse, the Christian learns how to melt her will into God's. Repentance is the threshold to God. When heat meets ice, the solid substance liquefies completely. Repentance liquefies the will of the flesh. Repentance is our daily fruit, our hourly washing, our minute-by-minute wake-up call, our reminder of God's creation, Jesus' blood, and the Holy Spirit's comfort. Repentance is the only no-shame solution to a renewed Christian conscience, because it proves the obvious, that God was right all along. This is why we seek to live humbly and confess our sins to each other and to God. We are preparing the way for Jesus to bring us his mercy and forgiveness."
Dear Father, thank you that you have given me the rhythm of regular repentance. Help me to cooperate with you as you do your work in me.
I'm living proof of what the mercy of God can do. If you knew me then, you'd believe me now. He turned my whole life upside down. took the old and he made it new. That's just what the mercy of God can do. Now I'm alive to tell the story, how I've overcome. It's his goodness and mercy and the power of his blood. I'm so glad that my freedom wasn't based on what I've done. The goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. So much power in the blood. The things I've said, the choices made that I regret. Wasn't based on what I've done, but the goodness and mercy and the power of the blood.
Power in the blood. by the blood of Jesus, be whole again. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can walk? Nothing but his blood, nothing but...